Hello, good afternoon students. Welcome in our new video. Here Sonu sir, today we are taking class 8 SST and in that we are taking civics portion. And in civics today we have chapter 3 understanding laws. And in that there is a very relevant topic today, Dowry Prohibition Act 1961. If you see the Hindi meaning of that topic, that is Dahej Unmoolan Kanun 1961. So students, before I start this topic, I have to give a brief introduction about this. Dowry, as you know, if in past time, if we see history of dowry, in past time, dowry was as voluntary act. Voluntary act. If we talk about dowry in past time, it was voluntary act, that means ऐच्छिक कार्य. So the work which we do with our wish, with our choice, that is voluntary. So in past time students, dowry was not act of compulsion, it was not compulsory act like this time, like nowadays. In past time, dowry was a kind of tradition, a kind of custom in that the, you know, the family of bride if the family of bride wants to give some gifts, some money or some, you know, clothes and ornaments, so they were free to give anything they wanted. There was not any kind of compulsion, there was not any kind of provision that you have to pay this one, you have to give these things, you have to bother these things. So this type of compulsion was not there. It was a kind of voluntary act which a bride's family used to give to groom's family as gift. But while the time passes, it became an compulsory act. While the time passes, it took shape of evil, it took form of evil, and by that this time we can say the poor family and the middle class family is feeling a kind of torture, a feeling of kind of exploitation by this dowry, because sometime if this dowry is demanded more and the demand will not satisfy, if the demand will not satisfy, then sometime in that cases sometime there is, you know, killing of bride also, there is extortion and there is exploitation and, you know, domestic violence on bride and on women. So this is has been shown, students, and this has been seen in past, and nowadays this evil has been expanded itself, and that is why there was an act which was passed in 1961 to prohibit this act, to prohibit this dowry system, to stop this dowry system. For this topic we are going to discuss today. So students, in your course book page number 200, and our topic is Dowry Prohibition Act, we see the Hindi meaning of that Dahej Unmoolan Kanun 1961. So I am going to start. The money, property and goods given by a bride to her husband or his family on their marriage this one is dowry. So if we see the simple reduction, so what are the gifts and money and property are given to groom's family, to boy's family, from girl's family is dowry. The dowry system has been prevalent in India for a long time. Initially, it was voluntary act of bride's family that became an act of compulsion later. So in past time, practice of dowry was there, but it was voluntary act. It was a work of choice that she carried. And the bride's family were free to give what the property they wanted, what the money they wanted, and what the gift they wanted. There was not any kind of compulsion or any kind of, you know, necessity or essentiality. Totally, it was the voluntary act. It was act of choice. It was happiness and harmony of the bride's family who wanted to give something to the boy's family or the groom's family. But the time passes, it became an act of compulsion. It became an, you know, act of evil that people started demanding dowry and people started giving dowry. And it is very interesting to discuss, students, that if we talk about the history of 20 year or 10 year, so we see that nowadays the best job is there, dowry will be moved. If the, you know, boy is looking good, dowry will be moved. If the girl is not looking good, dowry will be moved. If, you know, the family of girls or family of brides wanted to choose a, you know, boy who is earning more and more, so they have to pay more dowry, they have to give more dowry. So now it has become compulsion, and to stop this act, in 1961 government passed an act known as Dowry Prohibition Act 1961, and by that from there it started to check the dowry which is practiced. So the money, property and goods given by bride to her husband or family in their marriage is known as dowry. The dowry system has been prevalent in India for a long time. Initially, it was voluntary act of the bride's family that become an act of compulsion later on. In many cases, if the demands of the groom's family are not met, the bride is not harassed and tortured, but both emotionally and physically, but also killed in extreme cases. So sometimes, if the demand is not fulfilled, they do harassment, they do torture of bride in demand of dowry. So to stop this all, the increasing number of dowry deaths and dowry related crime led to the passing of the dowry prohibition. So by seeing these dowry deaths and, you know, demand of dowry and then dowry related crime started increasing, then government passed an act that is known as Dowry Prohibition Act in 1961 by the Indian legislature. This act prohibits giving or taking of dowry in any form. So anyone who gives, takes or abets dowry is liable for imprisonment for a minimum of 5 years, along with a fine of ₹15,000 or the amount of value of the dowry received, whichever is greater. So some penalties and some fines were adopted from that time, and to check, to prohibit, you know, dowry. The dowry prohibition, maintenance of list of present to the bride and the bridegroom rules were enacted in 1985. And further in 1985, after 24 years, and similar and different similar act was passed, and that was known as dowry prohibition, and it was maintenance of lists of present to the bride and bridegroom. So what the presents have been interchanged or given to each other, or mainly presents given from the bride's, from bride's side. So it is, you know, listed in this act, and from 1985, so people had to show what they had given, what they had taken, and if the list is, kind of any check, and if there is any kind of, extortion or any kind of demand which is forcefully taken, so then it would be in charge of Dowry Act. So if Liszt was enacted and Wolff was enacted in 1985 to further curb the practice of dowry, which directs the bride and the groom to prepare and maintain separate lists of the presents received at the time of marriage. What the list, what the presents they had or they had achieved or taken has to show to the government. This act was passed there. Then we see students, laws to prevent female feticide. So after this Dowry Prohibition Act, it was another evil of our society. Students, that is, if someone is giving birth, if some, you know, woman is giving birth to a girl child or a female child, then or female feticide, so then it was in some states that they used to kill that female feticide, that female child who is not born till now. So it was also an evil of our society. And if we talk about our next topic, so before that there is, and I wish I knew, in that statistics reveal that every hour one woman dies in India in a dowry related incident. In a report published in 2015, Uttar Pradesh topped the list with 7,048 dowry related cases. So as we are now most populated state, but behalf of that, in spite of that, we see that in Uttar Pradesh the dowry related cases is on the top, or dowry related deaths and crimes are on the top. So it is very important to know that there are some other evils which is raised in our country and have to prevent it. So now, after dowry prohibition, there was an act and there was a law which was passed, laws to prevent female feticide. Laws to prevent. Laws to prevent. Female. कन्या भ्रूण हत्या के खिलाफ कानून, कन्या भ्रूण हत्या के खिलाफ कानून. सो स्टूडेंट्स, लाइक डाउरी सिस्टम, देयर वाज एन एविल एंड अनदर एविल इन आवर सोसाइटी which was killing of female feticide. In wish of a boy, a son, people used to kill their female child in, you know, before birth, and only because of this dowry, because people started thinking that if they give birth to a female child, then after some years, you know, then when she would be of 18 years, then they had to pay dowry for her. So the reason of that and the evil of dowry was attracted to a new evil, that was killing of female feticide, because people started thinking that if female child would be more in counting, so how would be possible to marry them, and how the dowry will be collected for them. So that is why in some states like Haryana, Rajasthan, and in some Pashmi, you know, western Uttar Pradesh, and in some part of Maharashtra, some rural part of Maharashtra, and some other states, you can search for that mainly. So students, there are many states till now, and in past time we have seen some phenomena and incidents of that. That there was killing of female feticide, there was killing of female zygote, before birth, and that is why there was need to make a law, to frame a law who can prevent female feticide. So students, the killing of female child by terminating pregnancy is known as female feticide. So by CT scan and by some, you know, other method, by, you know, we see ultrasound, so by some other methods people used to see and used to know the gender, you know, sex of child, either she is girl or he is boy. After knowing that if she is a girl or she was a girl, so they used to kill her because it would be harder to marry her because of dowry and some other topics. So that is why they started terminating pregnancy while they known that if the child is girl. So then it started female fratricide killing. And the major reason behind this is the consideration of daughters as a financial burden and sons as an asset. So people started thinking sons as an asset. Asset, what is asset? Asset, that is puji, dhan sampada. And this boy was seen as an asset and girl seen as burden, because they had to pay dowry for her. But boy was taking dowry, boy was receiving dowry, that is why he was asset and girl was burden of money. So that is why this feeling started and this thinking started, and that is why some kind of consideration of daughters as a financial burden started and sons as an asset. A son is preferred to a daughter by many people because a large amount of money has to be spent during her marriage, and including dowry. Rising the number of instances of female fratricide has resulted in decline in the number of females in India. There are 927 females per 1,000 males according to the 2001 census. So people started doing ultrasound, checking the child, that what is gender of that child, what is sex of that child. And after knowing that if there is girl child, so they started terminating of the pregnancy and killing that girl child and female fratricide in stomach and in before birth. So students, it was an evil, and by that evil in 2001 census we know counting of population. So we found that only on 1,000 men there are only 927 women because of this killing of female fratricide. So to stop this, the fifth government passed the Prenatal Diagnostic Techniques Act, Regulation and Prevention of Misuse Act, or the PNDT Act in 1994. It came into effect on 1 January 1996. This act declared the determination and disclosure of the sex of the fetus to be illegal. So students, this ultrasound and this computer technology which was there to know the gender and sex of inborn child and who is going to born on birth. So after this act that was passed on in 1994, that was Prenatal Diagnostic Techniques Act, Regulation and Prevention of Misuse Act, or PNDT Act in 1994, and it came into effect on 1 January 1996. This act declared that determination and disclosure. So this determination and disclosure, determination, पहचान, disclosure, kind of abortion or killing of that female fratricide. So this abortion and this determination for recognition of child that either she is girl child or boy child. So this became an illegal act after passing this act that is known as in short form PNDT from 1 January 1996. And any violation of this act can lead to imprisonment and fine. And if somebody is doing violation of this act, so imprisonment is guaranteed. And the act was amended as the Preconception and Prenatal Diagnostic Techniques Act in 2004. And these two acts, and this one act or two acts of 1994, which started in 1996, it became amended act as Preconception and Prenatal Diagnostic Techniques Act in 2004, which prohibits parents from finding out the sex of fetus through an ultrasound. So then after clearing this act in 2004, they prohibit ultrasound. People can't check their child before birth. Are they girl child or boy child, if someone is doing like that, it would be the matter of imprisonment and fine. So students, it also prohibits doctor from disclosing the sex of the fetus to the parents, and nobody can. Disclosure means जानी करना, बता देना. So doctor can know that what is child, but they cannot disclose, they cannot open that thing, they cannot say something about that, and they cannot also determine and recognize that thing. So the female child cannot be checked in abdomen that he is female child or he is a boy. We can't check this. So this act is we can't determine the child sex, and we can't do disclosure. We can't say to anyone if we're going to know that this is girl child. Doctor can't share this thing with parents. So this act was started from there, and there is topic students. I knew the Beti Bachao Beti Padhao Yojana was launched on 22nd January 2015 by the Ministry of Women and Child Development. If you see the Hindi of this ministry, Mahila Ayog Bal Vikas Mantralay. So this Ministry of Women and Child Development started this Beti Bachao and Beti Padhao Yojana from 22nd January 2015. Government of India aims to at generating awareness and improving the efficiency of welfare services for women. So this Yojana has been started to promote awareness about women, about girl child, and about education of girls and women, and the importance of them, the significance of them is mentioned. So students, we concluded today two topic: dowry provision act 1961 and laws to prevent female fratricide, and very important topic both are there. So students, in homework you have to write small summary. You can write check word body of these pages, checkpoint of these pages, IBC I knew, and you have to do further study for that. So students, if there is any query, you can ask on my number. We will meet in next video. Till then, have a nice day. Thank you.